Now, let's look into the pronouns like, agar hum ye sare pronouns use karte hain, toh kya hota hai? Agar hum pronouns use karte hain, jaise each ya each one, every, everyone, everybody, anyone, anybody, someone, somebody, no one, nobody. Agar hum ye sare pronouns use karte hain, in that case, inhe hum ek single person ya ek singular subject maante hain. So, in that case, hamara jo verb hoga, wo bhi hamara singular hi hoga. But, agar hum koi subject aisa lete hain, jaise ki none, none ek aisa hai pronoun jo ki it can be a singular and it can be plural also, depending on their conditions. Lekin each one, every, everyone, everybody, anyone, anybody, someone, somebody, no one, nobody, ye hamesha aapke ek singular subject hi rahenge. So obviously inke saath jo verb hoga, that will always be a singular verb. None, we will look into the examples. Now let's look into the example for every one of them, one after another. Now, these are some examples for the pronouns we just talked about. Every boy and girl of my class is intelligent. If we look into the first example, हमने देखा था कि जब हम किसी भी subject को and के साथ जोड़ते हैं, तो वो plural बन जाता है. लेकिन क्योंकि यहाँ पे हमने word use किया, every boy or I can say each boy, हर लड़का और लड़की. So here I'm talking about one boy and every one girl. So in that case, because we have the use the word pronoun every, so the verb here is singular. Every boy and girl of my class is intelligent, not are intelligent. क्योंकि यहाँ पर ये word आया. तो अगर आप ये सारे words देखते हैं अपने question paper में, so always remember, it will always take a singular verb. Let's look into the other example. Does anyone, anyone यानी कि कोई एक, does anyone want ice cream? क्योंकि यहाँ anyone आया, obviously here the the helping verb that we have used here in for questions is a singular helping verb, not a plural one. Does anyone want ice cream? No one has the power to destroy India. No one. Kisi ke paas power nahi hai. No one has. So this verb here is a singular verb that we have used. Next is someone. Kisi ne, kisi ek ne, kisi ne. Someone tells me, because someone is a pronoun among the list that we talked about. So the verb here we are going to use as a singular verb. Someone tells me that this house is haunted. Kisi ne, I don't know kaun tha, but koi tha, koi ek shayad, kisi ne mujhe bataya ki ye jo ghar hai, ye haunted hai, bhootiya hai. So don't go there, maybe, anything like that. So us case mein, someone is some one person I'm talking about. So someone tells me that this house is haunted. यहाँ पर अगर हम examples देखते हैं, like you know, each, every, anyone, none, someone, ये सारे वो pronouns हैं which will always take a singular subject. But as I told you earlier for none, so now we will look into the example with none, because that can be singular also and that can be plural also depending on the subject. Next, examples related to none. If we see here, none of the cake. यहाँ पर किसी हम एक केक की बात करें, कोई भी केक नहीं खाया. None of the cake, because here the cake is singular, so the verb here we have used is was. None of the cake was eaten. कोई भी केक, कोई भी, I mean not even a single cake, किसी ने खाया. None of the cake was eaten. Next example says, none of the children, मतलब कोई भी बच्चा. None of the children, none and children. Children here is a plural, that's why it is none of the children were hungry. None of the children were present in the class. Koi bhi bachcha nahi aaya tha. So here, because the subject here is plural, we are going to use word. Aapko dhyan rakhna hai, none of ke baad jo bhi hum subject use kar rahe hain, if it is a singular, the verb will be singular. If it is a plural one, the verb will be plural. The next is, in case of the words like fraction, majority and percentage, if we use these words, like fraction, majority and percentage, etc. In that case, the verb is always according to the noun that follows the preposition of. Jo bhi hamara preposition of ke baad jo hamara noun aayega, uske upar hamara ye depend karega. Like if I say 20% of the course is over, mera 20% course jo hai wo khatam ho gaya hai. Yahan pe humne use kiya hai preposition of, and then the word, the noun here is course. So because the course I'm talking about, it can be any one course, it is singular, so it is over. Lekin agar main course ki jagah courses kar dun, that means I'm talking about all of courses, sare courses mein se 20%, right? So 20% of the courses, in that case the verb will change from singular to plural, kyunki subject aapka plural ho gaya hai. So 20% of the courses are over. Let's look into another example. If I say a majority of people like Mr. Modi, Prime Minister Modi, Mr. Modi. So in that case, if I use here majority of people, because people is plural, so here the verb itself is plural. So it's a majority of people like Modi. Or if I say a fraction of people don't like Modi. Fraction means a few number of people, they don't like Modi. Yahan par bhi humne use kiya hai people. So again, people being plural, so here your verb, the helping verb here is a plural one. So is cheez ka aapko dhyan rakhna hai ki jo bhi aap preposition use kar rahe hain, uske baad jo aapka noun aayega, agar wo singular hai to aapka verb singular hoga, agar wo plural hai to aapka verb plural hoga. So that is something you need to keep in mind, you need to see keep preposition ke baad. Lekin that is only in case of the words like fraction, majority or percent, not with any other, right? So here you have to look into, keep that into mind. Now the next one is like if we say with adverbs like here and there, agar aisa koi sentence hai jahan pe hamare adverbs here and their use hote hain, in that case the verb is always according to the subject that follows the verb. To jo bhi hamara verb subject verb ko follow karega, singular or plural, depending on the verb will be a singular one or a plural one. Like if I say that here book you were looking for, okay, now I have not put anything out here. If it is one book, if it is, if I say here is book, so if it is book then the verb will be is. Here is book, here is the book that you were looking for. Or if I say here are the books, I can also say the books, I mean here books. Ye wo kitabe hain jo aap dhoond rahe the. So if it becomes books then it is are. But if it is only a book, then we will use there, here is the book that you were looking for. The next is like there is not a single person, or there is not a person whom I can trust. See, if I talk about there dash not a person, कोई भी एक आदमी नहीं है जिस पर मैं विश्वास कर सकती हूँ. So there is not a single person, not even a single person whom I can trust on. So ऐसे केस में आपको हमेशा ध्यान रखना है कि अगर आपका जो सब्जेक्ट है, जो वर्ब के बाद आ रहा है, वो सिंगुलर है, then the verb will be singular. If it is plural, the verb will be plural. So that is something you need to keep in mind. Then we have if there are subjects which has a positive and a negative. So in that case, whether it is a singular one or a plural, usse hame koi fark nahi padta. I mean, positive singular singular bhi ho sakte hain, plural plural bhi ho sakte hain, singular plural bhi ho sakte hain. But only thing is, in that case, the verb always goes with the positive subject. जो भी हमारा पॉजिटिव सब्जेक्ट है, अगर पॉजिटिव सब्जेक्ट हमारा सिंगुलर है तो सिंगुलर वर्ब होगा, अगर पॉजिटिव सब्जेक्ट हमारा प्लूरल है तो हमारा वर्ब प्लूरल होगा. लाइक इफ आई से इट इज़ द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड नॉट द मिनिस्टर्स, इट इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड नॉट द मिनिस्टर्स हु मेक द पॉलिसी or who make the decision, if I say. In this case, यहाँ पर हम बात कर रहे हैं प्राइम मिनिस्टर और मिनिस्टर्स की, जो कि डिसीजन लेते हैं. अब यहाँ पर इफ यू सी, इट इज़ द मिनिस्टर्स. सो हेयर इट इज़ नेगेटिव वन इज विद द मिनिस्टर, नॉट इज विद द मिनिस्टर्स, एंड दिस इज़ अ पॉजिटिव वन. सो बिकॉज इट इज़ अ सिंगुलर, सो हेयर इट विल बी a singular one is, it is the prime minister and not the ministers who make the decision. Lekin agar main ise change kar dun, isko main negative aur usko positive kar dun, let's look into that. If I say it is not the prime minister but the ministers, it is not the prime minister, the ministers who make the decision. So here the ministers, it becomes the plural one. So it, Dheera sir, sorry, is wale ko dobara record kar sakte hain? Ha, continue kar dun, but aap ise kaat dijiyega please. Ha, sorry, मुझसे बोलने में गलती हो गई. हाँ जी सर. द नेक्स्ट इज इफ वी हैव टू सब्जेक्ट्स, it can be a singular singular or plural plural or singular plural, but they are positive and negative. Agar hamare paas do subjects hain jo ek positive hai aur ek negative, then the verb will always compound with the the positive subject. Hamesha verb hamara positive subject ke sath jayega. Agar wo singular hai, then the verb will be singular. Agar wo plural hai, then the verb will be plural. If I say it is the prime minister and not the ministers who take decisions. So here if I say, if I look into this, yahan par prime minister is positive and the minister is negative. So if I see here their singular subject is positive, so it is the prime minister and the not the ministers who takes decisions or who makes decisions. Yahan par aayega kyun, kyunki hamara jo positive subject hai wo singular hai, so the verb will be singular. Lekin agar main ise interchange kar dun, if I say it is let's say not the prime minister but the ministers who, now agar यहाँ पे देखते हैं, सो द नेगेटिव बिकम्स द सिंगुलर वन एंड द पॉजिटिव इज द प्लूरल वन. सो हेयर इट विल बी, इट इज नॉट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर बट द मिनिस्टर्स हु टेक द डिसीजंस, राइट. सो वी हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ द पॉजिटिव एंड द नेगेटिव वन. सो लाइक इट इज नॉट द एमडी बट द डायरेक्टर्स, द अदर डायरेक्टर्स who finalize the policies. So directors, not the MD. So directors is plural. So we use it in that case with the plural one. So aapko aise cases mein, in case of positive and negative, hamesha dhyan rakhna padega ki positive kaun sa hai. Agar positive hamara singular hai, verb is singular. Positive hamara plural hai, the verb is plural. So these are some common errors that we usually find while doing your finding the errors, common errors related to subject verb agreement. Aur bhi bahut sare hote hain, errors can be related to tenses and your prepositions and modals, but today the tense, the subject verb agreement was done. This is what the common errors we talked about, and we are doing tenses. In tenses you get to know the common errors that people do while doing their tenses. Now let's look into some exercise. Now we are giving you some exercises. You can try at your